बारायला पाहिजे. चलो वी कॅन स्टार्ट नाव अवर लेक्चर. गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. सो इन द प्रिव्हियस लेक्चर वी हॅव कम्प्लीटेड द सिरीज रेझोनन्स पार्ट. इन दॅट वी हॅव सॉल्व टू एक्झाम्पल्स ऑल्सो. वी हॅव डिराइव्ह द एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ रेझोनन्स फ्रिक्वेन्सी and based on that two example we have solved, and after that we have discussed and completed also that impedance of a series resonance circuit, that part we have completed. Now today we are going to continue the same topic, that impedance and phase angle we have taken. So in that phase angle is remaining. So phase angle of a series resonance circuit we are going to discuss now. So I will share the PDF now. Whiteboard. Just 2 minutes. Okay. The screen is visible?
Yes, sir.
So in the last point discussed, that is the impedance of a series resonance circuit. So we have discussed it, impedance versus frequency. So there are the different impedances are there in the series RLC circuit. So those are the we can say that XL, then XC, then total impedance Z. Okay, so all these impedances we have varied with respect to frequency and how it will affect, how it will going to change, okay, at different frequency range, how it will behave, that all point we have covered in the previous lecture. So today we can start the next point, that is the phase angle. In that only, because we have taken A and B part, so B part we can start, that is the phase angle of a series resonance circuit. So we are discussing now the series resonance part. It is series resonance only. Okay. So first of all, I will draw the graph. And with the help of that graph, we can try to understand how the phase angle will vary with respect to frequency in a series RLC circuit. So this is the y-axis. This we can consider as a x-axis. On x-axis, we can take the frequency f, that is in hertz. Okay, it is zero. And on y-axis, positive and negative y-axis, we can take the phase angle. Phase angle. Okay, phase angle is always represented by theta. So if you are considering y-axis, it starts from 0° to theta. This is 180 we can consider like this. So theta, we are considering this as a 0°. This as a plus 90°. Here it is my 180°. Here it is 270° positive. If you are considering reverse, it is minus 90°. It is minus 180°. It is minus 270°. That already we have discussed in the phasor diagram. Okay. So 180 will be here. We can write somewhere here. 180° positive as well as negative, plus minus. Now the phasor diagram, somewhere we can get here the resonant frequency, that we can mark the straight line here. So this frequency, we can call it as resonant frequency. This is FR at this point. Okay. So if you are drawing the graph of this phase angle variation with respect to frequency, that will be like Okay, it is like curve. It is not a straight line. It is like a curve. So here, as usual, when upper is greater than when frequency is greater than resonant frequency, XL is more than XC. कारण एक्सएल हे इन्फिनिटीकडे जातं आणि एक्सी झिरोकडे जातं, त्यामुळे इंडक्टिव्ह पार्ट डॉमिनंट असतो. इंडक्टिव्ह पार्ट विल बी डॉमिनंट, मोर इंडक्टिव्ह पार्ट, बिकॉज इंडक्टिव्ह रिएक्टन्स इज मोर. सो इन दॅट केस आय लॅग्स बिहाइंड व्ही एस, दॅट ऑलरेडी वी हॅव डिस्कस. सो फ्रॉम बिटवीन झिरो टू एफ आर, एक्सी इज ग्रेटर दॅन एक्सएल. And in that case, I leads the VS. But at resonant frequency, XL is equal to XC. That already we have discussed. So this is the graph. I will give the figure number 2. That is the phase angle versus frequency. Variation in series RLC circuit. Okay, so you can consider here you can consider -90 degrees, here you can consider +90 degrees. म्हणजे असं जर तुम्ही कंपेअर केलं वाय एक्सिस, इफ आर कंपेअरिंग दिस पॉइंट. Okay, so we can discuss now some points regarding this graph. So first of all, we can take when frequency is in between 0 and FR. The 0 pekshe jaast hai ni? Sorry. When frequency is between 0 and FR, this is the first range. Okay, so 0 to FR. In that case, what will happen that we can discuss here. In that case, XC becomes greater than XL. Due to this, current I leads applied voltage Vs. Okay, so the meaning is that the phase angle कमी होत जातो, म्हणजे तो -90 कडून -80 minus असं कमी होत जातो, झिरो कडे येतो. At resonant frequency the phase angle becomes 0 degrees. Okay, the phase angle theta decreases as frequency increases. जसं फ्रिक्वेन्सी वाढवत जातो 0 टू एफ आर कडे, तसं फेज अँगल काय होणार आहे, डिक्रीज होणार आहे. मीन्स वी कॅन से दॅट -90 degrees टू 0 degrees, इट विल बी द चेंजेस. ओके, दॅट यू कॅन अंडरस्टँड. नाउ सेकंड पार्ट at resonant frequency f is equal to fr, at that time what will happen, xl becomes equal to xc, therefore resonance occurs. Next point, current I becomes in phase with applied voltage Vs. In phase is very important, applied voltage Vs. Okay, so at that point we can say that phase angle theta becomes 0 degrees. I understand. Now next, third point, that is when frequency is greater than FR but less than infinite. Sorry, this is wrong. when frequency is greater than fr and less than infinite. The infinite peksha kami aani regional frequency peksha jaast hai, means this region. At that point, XL becomes greater than XC. Okay, XL becomes greater than XC. Means inductive reactance most asnar hai. Due to this, current I lags behind Vs, applied voltage Vs. Okay, so due to which, what will happen? The phase angle. Phase angle increases as frequency increases. So it becomes theta equal to plus 90 degree. So total variation will be minus 90 to plus 90. Means kiti asnar total variation? 180 degree. So that will be the conclusion. So phase difference. Maximum will be 180 degree. Okay, that is called as out of phase. Maximum phase difference is 180 degree. Okay, so this will be the concept, or this will be the phase angle variation with respect to frequency in a series resonance circuit. So take a 30 second, read it properly. If any doubt, any questions will be there, you can freely ask. Okay. Over. Any doubt?
No, sir.
So we have to solve one example here. So this example I will consider as question number 3, because two problems we have solved already. For the circuit shown in figure, determine first is resonant frequency, second one is impedance at resonance, then third one is impedance when frequency is 10 hertz below resonant frequency. Okay, this is the 10. So this is the 10. Similarly, the fourth point is impedance when frequency is 10 hertz above resonant frequency. What is the meaning of this one? We have to find out resonant frequency first of all. Then at resonance, what is the impedance? That already know, that is Z is equal to R. So after that, resonant frequency already we know. So we have to take resonant frequency plus 10 as well as resonant frequency minus 10. Current impedance we are going to find out at frequency 10 hertz below resonant frequency and 10 hertz above resonant frequency. F1, F2, aplyala don frequency kadav lagel. Okay. So circuit diagram, I will show that because without knowing the value of LNC, we cannot find out resonant frequency here. So circuit must be there. So this is a resistor. This is inductor. This is capacitor they have given. This is the applied voltage Vs. So this is 10 ohm. This is 0.1 H. And this is 10 microfarad. Okay. So this is the question now. So first of all, carefully read the question and observe the circuit. And then you can start to solve. And when you are starting, what are the things they have given from the circuit, from the descriptive part in the question that you can note down initially. So given R is equal to, resistor value is given as 10 ohm. L is equal to 0.1 Henry and C is equal to 10 microfarad. Okay. Now next, first of all, we have to find out resonant frequency. Resonant frequency. That is denoted by FR. So what is the formula of resonant frequency of series RLC circuit?
1 upon 2 pi under root LC.
Okay, 1 upon 2 pi into under root LC. So put the value of LNC and tell me the answer. L is 0.1. And this is 10 into 10 raised to minus 6. Micro means 10 raised to minus 6. 10 into 10 raised to minus 6, 10 microfarad. No? So calculate and tell what is the answer of FR. Anyone have calculated? Yes.
Zero point one five nine.
What kilohertz?
Yes, sir. Kilo.
Okay, so that is nothing but 159.2 hertz. Okay, so this is the answer. 0.159 kilohertz ayala paije kiwa 159.2 hertz. So we got the resonant frequency. Okay, first part is completed. The second part is what? Impedance at resonance. Impedance at resonance. We know that already. At resonance, what is the impedance?
R.
Yes. So you can write Z is equal to R. Z is equal to R. So what is that value R? That is 10
ohm.
Yes. So this is the answer. Okay. Third step. Impedance when frequency is 10 hertz below resonant frequency. Manje aplyala below manje F1 consider karuya. F1 is equal to FR plus, sorry, below manje minus karala paise. FR minus 10. Manje resonant frequency peksha 10 hertz ni kami. Manje FR minus 10. Ha jo frequency that is F1. We can call it as. Okay. So FR kiti hai 159.2 minus 10. Manje F1 kiti jala aplyala. 149.2 hertz. Okay. Now next. Ata ya ela impedance karayche. F2 is equal to FR plus 10. Okay. Manje ha. The impedance when frequency is 10 hertz above. So FR is equal to 159.2 plus 10. Manje ha kiti jala F2. That is 169.2. Okay, upon frequency card. This is not the third point we can generally take. So third point I will take here. Okay, now impedance at F1, we can say impedance at F1 equal to 149.2 hertz. That we have to calculate. मग त्याच्यासाठी फॉर्म्युला काय आहे झेड चा? सो झेड इज इक्वल टू मॅग्निट्यूड ऑफ झेड इज इक्वल टू आर स्क्वेअर अंडर रूट आर स्क्वेअर प्लस एक्सएल वन, कारण आपण फ्रिक्वेन्सी एफ वन घेतो त्यामुळे एक्सएल वन मायनस एक्सी वन ब्रॅकेट स्क्वेअर. दिस इज द फॉर्म्युला यूज टू कॅल्क्युलेट द इम्पेडन्स ऍट फ्रिक्वेन्सी बिलो रेझोनंट फ्रिक्वेन्सी बाय 10 हर्ट्ज, म्हणजेच 149.2 ला आपल्याला कॅल्क्युलेट. त्यातला आर चं व्हॅल्यू कॉन्स्टंट असतो, आर व्हॅल्यू वी कॅन गेट डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम द सर्किट. एक्सएल वन वी हॅव टू कॅल्क्युलेट, एक्सी वन वी हॅव टू कॅल्क्युलेट, देन वी कॅन पुट हियर अँड वी कॅन गेट द आन्सर. ओके, सो कॅन यू कॅल्क्युलेट नाव एक्सएल वन? नाव एक्सएल वन इज व्हॉट? एक्सएल वन म्हणजे काय? 2πF1 इंटू एल, 2πF इंटू एल ना. मग एफ काय करायचं? आपल्याला एफ वन घ्यायचे. सो कॅल्क्युलेट, पुट द व्हॅल्यू 2π इंटू एफ वन इज 149.2 इंटू एल व्हॅल्यू इज 0.1. सो व्हॉट इज द एक्सएल वन?
93.74
आलंय माझं, बरोबर आहे?
74
आले.
93.69 74
हा माझा आन्सर 93.74 आले. एक्सी वन टू कॅल्क्युलेट नाव, एक्सी वन दॅट इज 1/2πF1 इंटू सी. सो 1/2π इंटू 149.2 इंटू सी इज 10⁻⁶. What is the XC1? What is the XC1?
106.72.
Yes, 106.7 kiwa 6 apun ghuya, maza 106.6 aale. Okay, so XL1 we got 93.74, XC1 we got 106. And R is 10. So all value you can put here and you can tell me the impedance now.
175.3.
What is the value of impedance? Therefore, Z is equal to, I will put under root R square means 10 square. नेक्स्ट प्लस एक्सएल किती आले? 93.74 मायनस 106.6 ब्रॅकेट स्क्वेअर, दॅट यू हॅव टू फाइंड आउट. किती आले सांगा मला आन्सर?
16.3
येते बघा.
16.29.
हा तेच, 16.29 म्हणजे 16.29. यस यस yes, it is okay. 16.29, 16.28, 16.29, that is okay. 16.3 round up getle mi 16.3. so this is the answer. Similarly we can solve for fourth one, impedance at F2. tisra samajle ki chautha point samajla? Impedance at F2 that is equal to 169.2 hertz. so that Z is equal to under root R square plus XL2 minus XC2 bracket square. Now XL2 you can calculate. XL2 is equal to 2πF2 into L. 2πF2 is 169.2 and L is 0.1. So what is XL2? Same method, only frequency value will change. So XL2 I got 106.31. you can cross check. XC2 काय येणार बघा? 1/2πF2 into C. So 1/2πF2 is what? 169.2 and C is 10⁻⁶. So XC2 I got 62.94.4.064 ohm. So once you got XL2, XC2 and R value already know, so you can put in the equation. So Z is equal to R square means 10 square plus XL2 is 106.31 minus 94.06 bracket square. So if you are solving, you can get Z is equal to 15.81. This will be the answer. So simple problem is that only formula and calculation should be correct. इथं काय जास्त डोकं लढवायची काही गरज नाहीये. द फर्स्ट चॅप्टर इज व्हेरी क्रुशियल. इन दॅट वी हॅव टू यूज द स्किल्स, नॉलेज, कन्सेप्ट अँड गुड मॅथमॅटिकल एक्सप्रेशन. हिअर इन दिस चॅप्टर इफ यू नो द फॉर्म्युलेज यू कॅन इझिली सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लेम्स. दीज न्युमरिकल प्रॉब्लेम्स टोटली बेस्ड ऑन फॉर्म्युलेज. येस, एनी क्वेश्चन? ओके, जस्ट वेट. एक्चुअली व्हॉट इज हॅपनिंग, वी आर युझिंग द व्हाइट बोर्ड नो. सो ऍट द लास्ट ऑफ वेन वी कॅन क्लोज दिस मीटिंग ऍट दॅट टाइम दॅट पीपीटी दॅट वी कॅन गेट. Okay, so I will show that, I will share it. Just wait. So I will share this one. Now it is visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. See, what is the question here? काय डाउट होता का? एनी डाउट इज देयर?
नो सर.
ओके, सो कॅन आय क्लोज दिस?
येस सर.
येस सर.
सो वी हॅव सॉल्व नाव दिस वन एक्झाम्पल. नेक्स्ट next point we can take. So the next point in current voltages and current in a series resonance circuit. So in that we can take first of all current and then we can move towards the voltage. The next point will be impedance and phase angle we have completed now. The next will be voltages and current in a series resonance circuit. So this is the topic we are going to discuss today, and we can try to complete this point. This is the big point, so we can try to complete this one. So first of all, a part I will take as the current versus frequency. Current I, variation with frequency, in series RLC circuit or series resonance circuit. Once we complete the current, then we can move towards the voltage, because voltage part is bigger one. Okay, so voltages and current in a series resonance circuit we are going to discuss today, and we can try to complete it. In that, the current I variation with respect to frequency that we are going to discuss now. So this is the x-axis. On x-axis, we can take the frequency f. It will increase from 0 to infinite. On y-axis, we can take two different parameters. One, we can take current I, and impedance Z. Okay, so on y-axis we have compared the impedance versus frequency in the previous lecture. Okay, but still we can use it because current and impedance are inversely proportional to each other. म्हणजे impedance कमी असेल तर current जास्त, impedance जास्त असेल तर current कमी. Okay, so for that purpose we have taken the impedance here. So the main we are going to focus on current. So first of all, how the impedance will behave with respect to frequency, with the variation in frequency. That curve of Z in the previous graph. So at resonant frequency, at frequency zero, the impedance is maximum. So it will start from this point. So this is the impedance. This is the impedance Z curve. Okay, so at frequency zero, it is infinite. At frequency infinite, it is also infinite. But at resonant frequency, somewhere here, we can consider at resonant frequency FR, the impedance is minimum. And that minimum is nothing but resistive part, that is R. Okay, so this we can consider as a resistive part, that is the R. So at resonant frequency, what is the impedance? That is the R. Now, how the we can say that how the current will, what will be the nature of current now? If impedance is like this, whether the current is exactly opposite. At frequency f is equal to zero, at frequency f is equal to zero, inductor short hoto. One capacitor cast to open. Okay. If capacitor becomes open, then circuit becomes open. If circuit becomes open, current value becomes zero. Barabara? Tamula at frequency zero, current is zero. Now next, when the resonant frequency is there, at that time current will be maximum. And parat jeva frequency infinite hoto, frequency somewhere up we can take here. When frequency becomes infinite, XL becomes infinite and XC becomes zero. मग एक्सएल इन्फिनिट असा अर्थ तो इंडक्टर ओपन आहे. इंडक्टर जर ओपन झाला तर करंट झिरो. सो द ग्राफ विल बी लाईक दिस. or would I love? See, this is bus to tie over. Don't listen. Okay. So my voice is audible now?
Yes, sir.
So this we can consider as a figure number three. Three is over. Figure number four. That is the current I variation with frequency. With frequency in series RLC circuit. Okay, current I variation with frequency in series RLC circuit we can take. So if you are observing the graph, the impedance and current, because they are inversely proportional, that's why exactly opposite they will come. Okay, the nature of the graph of impedance versus frequency and current versus frequency will be exactly opposite to each other, because current is inversely proportional to impedance. Okay, meeta litho relation. I is inversely proportional to Z. Okay, manje Z jar maximum asel, tar ta current minimum asto. Ita baga Z infinite hai, tamla current zero hai. Here also Z is infinite, that's why current is zero. But when the impedance is minimum, at that time current is maximum. So this current is maximum, I will show that one at this point. So it will be maximum current at resonant frequency. So maximum current kadhi asnar hai? At resonant frequency only, because at resonant frequency, what is the value of resistors? That is very small.
Zero.
Impedance, that is only R. Fakta R as runner hai. Tamulo maximum current asnar. Okay. So this is the variation of current with respect to frequency. So for reference, we have taken the impedance curve. So we can try to understand with the help of descriptive part. So point wise, we can try to discuss. Next one. The figure number four shows the variation of impedance. The figure number four shows the variation of impedance Z and current I with frequency. The figure four shows the variation of impedance and current I, okay, current I with frequency, that is shown in the figure number 4. Okay, current I with frequency of a series resonant circuit, of a series resonant circuit. So second point, when frequency f is equal to 0, okay, when frequency f is equal to 0, I am talking about this point. So at that point, what will happen? XL becomes 0. XL becomes 0 ohm and XC becomes what? Infinite. So if XL becomes 0, what is the meaning of this? Inductor becomes short circuit. Inductor short. And XC infinite means
capacitor open.
Capacitor open झाला याचा अर्थ मी circuit diagram काढतो परत. Inductor मी short दाखवतो. This is the resistor R. Inductor I will make it open, short circuit, and capacitor will be open. And this your this supply voltage Vs. Okay, so capacitor is open. So here inductor L and here capacitor C I will write. If capacitor becomes open at frequency 0 and inductor becomes short, so what will be the value of current here?
Zero.
In open circuit current is 0, that already we know that. So I becomes equal to 0. So with respect to circuit diagram also we can verify it. So at frequency 0, what is the value of current? That is also 0. Are you understand?
This one. Yes, sir.
Okay. So next one, the next point we can consider. In this point, we can write the conclusion at frequency F. As frequency increases, now we are increasing the frequency from 0 to FR. Barabare? Ata 0 pasun apun FR kada frequency increase karte. So as frequency increases from 0 hertz to FR, what will happen? Current I increases and impedance decreases. And impedance Z decreases. Okay. Up to this point, anyone having doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. So the next point will be at resonant frequency FR, what will happen in the circuit as well as?
Current is maximum. Current impedance is maximum.
Yes, very good. So the current becomes maximum in that case, that we can discuss. So third point we can take. At resonant frequency. FR. Okay, so what will happen? F becomes FR. XL becomes equal to XC. Therefore, impedance Z becomes R, which is minimum. Okay, so due to which the current I becomes maximum. Okay, at resonant frequency FR, F is equal to FR, XL becomes equal to XC, impedance Z becomes equal to R, that is the minimum. Impedance are minimum, the other current becomes maximum. So current I in the circuit at the resonant, it will be maximum. Okay, so this is the concept what will happen at resonance. Now fourth point, when frequency f is greater than fr.
Resonant frequency.
And up to infinite we can consider. So at that time, what will happen?
XL increases.
XL greater than XC, due to which what will happen? Current I
becomes zero and impedance is high.
Yes. So current I, we can try to decrease. Current I decreases. Current I decrease hoto. And impedance
increases.
Impedance increases. Now, last point, at F is equal to infinite, what will happen? XL becomes infinite ohm, that is inductor open, and XC becomes zero, therefore capacitor short. एक जरी ओपन झाला तर करंट काय असणार आहे? झिरो. बरोबर आहे?
यस सर.
करंट आय बिकम्स झिरो. करंट आय बिकम्स झिरो ऍट एफ इज इक्वल टू इन्फिनिटी. सो वन सेकंड, रीड इट ऑल दीज पॉइंट्स. Any questions?
Okay. No, sir. So
current variation with respect to frequency in a series RLC circuit we have completed now. So the next point will be, different voltages are there in the series resonance circuit, that is a VS, VL, VR and VC. Okay, voltage across resistor, voltage across capacitor, voltage across inductor and applied voltage VS. So how they will vary with respect to frequency in a series RLC circuit, that we are going to discuss, as well as there are the two important derivations and complex derivation is there. It is not easy to understand that one. So these two derivations we are going to discuss. So what we can do now, we can close this first lecture now today. Now second lecture will be now at 11 o'clock same. Okay, so you can stay here. We can start the second lecture within 2 minutes. Don't leave this group.